My name is Moses Karanja. I am a research fellow at Strathmore University in Nairobi, Kenya, where I do research on internet and the politics around it, and recently, importantly, into how disruptions of connectivity are happening. So if I were to say broadly, it's about information controls and political processes in Africa. So when we are talking about information controls in the region, one of the key aspects we want to emphasize is a simple way of understanding exactly what internet networking is all about. And I always find the analogy of road traffic. A website could be an address, like say your mall, or where you go to cinema, or where you go to buy your groceries. And that can be compared to a website, but then for you to get there from where you are, so if we assume your home is your IP address of where you are, you need to connect through tunnels or roads or use traffic lights and all these kind of things. Now, when you put that within the context of information controls, it is more of someone trying to shut down a road because they feel you should not access websites around that area. So that's why platforms like Open Observatory of Network Interference, OONI, is such a great platform, because it gives you that view of how the traffic, the road traffic of the internet is working, and you can easily tell which address has been blocked, and by that I mean which websites are blocked, so censorship or incidences of internet disruptions. Using the OONI platform, we have managed to uncover censorship in countries like Ethiopia, where the government has intentionally blocked websites that have political content that is deemed confrontational or that opposes government position on issues. And through that kind of evidence, a lot of lobbying has happened that is not just about hearsay, where government can deny, compared to other incidences where you may say a website is blocked, but the government may just say, we don't know who blocked it, maybe it's a technical issue, maybe you don't have a connection. But here we are saying that this website are blocked, and this is how they are blocked. So to that extent, it's very helpful as a platform which is open to the public, and you don't have to worry about the research methodology because it's open and you can try to repeat it on your side. And the reproducibility of that methodology helps to verify that indeed these are not cooked up numbers. This is what's happening. At times, even if we don't see any instance of the web that has been blocked, we continue measuring the internet because in the future, we may want to know how the internet looked like at that particular point. And we want to do longitudinal analysis. We never know what will happen in the future. And so we want to see how are things back then, how are they now. And so that for me has been extremely important. Would encourage people to download the app, both on Android and iOS, which can help people do it from their vantage point. And that way we can collect as much information as possible about the internet and share it with the world. And that way we are contributing to a healthier internet, we are contributing to research methods that can help us understand internet better without having to pay so expensively for proprietary platforms that maybe may charge us and may not be accessible to a lot of people that actually need this kind of information.